Okay, are all my little kinderlach in bed?
Yep.
Negel Vasa prepared?
Yep, yep.
Kriya Shema said?
Yep, yep, yep.
With Kavana Tuki?
Yep, 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 yep.
Okay,
yep,
so...
Yep, 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 yep.
Okay, Tuki, that's enough. Now we're going to sing Hamalach.
Oh, and then country Yossi.
Yes, Kivi?
Well, you know I like to write songs.
Mm-hmm. You write great songs, Kivi.
Well, I wrote a new one using the words Hamalach HaGoel, which the choir is going to sing at the next dinner.
Wow, that sounds great. I'd love to hear it.
Well, just by coincidence, country Yossi, Moshe Shmuel is the soloist in the choir.
Really? Moshe Shmuel sings in the choir? I can't believe it. He can hardly talk. Moshe Shmuel, can you really sing?
Oh, yeah, oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, I talk funny, country Yossi, but oh, brother, can I sing?
Well, then go ahead. This I gotta hear.
Avinu used to bless Menashe and Ephraim right before he died. Now the Torah tells us that Yaakov blessed Yosef, but all we find is this bracha to Yosef's children. So where is Yosef's bracha? Well, some say that by blessing Yosef's children, that they be such tzaddikim that Avraham and Yitzchak would be proud to be associated with them, Yaakov was really blessing Yosef as well. Because having Yiddish and Achas from children is the biggest bracha a father could have. So just as Yosef was blessed through his children, let us hope that all fathers in Klal Yisroel will be blessed through their wonderful kinderlach. And may we be zeicha that Abraham, Yitzhak, and Yaakov always be proud to have us called by their names.